So, buddy, I better be formal. Now I'm not going to be formal. Listen, yeah, let's be formal for just a second. You know, your job, are you on your job? Are you one of these, we're in the middle of a pandemic. Are you on your job right now?
Yes, I am. I'm working from home.
Oh, so you one of them like middle class people that got computers and stuff like work from home. You're not like one of those essential workers that run away, you run around, you know, delivering stuff to people, food and medicines and stuff like that, no?
I wouldn't call myself an essential person or any of the other things that you've described. I would just call myself someone who is working from home with particular students who I have a relationship with. And in this case, the relationship is an independent study. So I'm working from home. Other than that, you know, there is nothing coming from my department or coming from the university that requires me to do anything else but work with my independent study students.
Ah, so if you had classes, you wouldn't do anything.
No, if I had classes other than an independent study student, I would still be working with the classes, but I'd be working with the classes online either through Blackboard or some other medium.
Yeah, Blackboard. I know Blackboard.
But fortunately, I wouldn't say fortunate, but this semester I didn't have any classes. What I did have was independent study students.
So you're in a catbird seat. My goodness. But let me ask you, are things going to change to such a degree that we won't recognize what higher education is anymore or tertiary education is anymore? What's going to happen?
I think things will change. I mean, things were going to change irrespective of this pandemic that we're going through. Things were going to change because of technology and other innovations that are being put into place. Mm-hmm. So those changes are coming along gradually. And in fact, it will get to a particular point in time. I'm assured of this. That in a particular point in time, the teaching as we now know it will be obsolete. That teaching will be done through either robots or some other media, but the in-person teaching that we're now familiar with that we've been doing for several hundred years, where you have a particular professor standing in front of a classroom, eventually that will be obsolete. It'll be teaching by internet or some other sources, even maybe possibly teaching from, brain implants. But the technology seems to be irreversible, so it's moving in that direction. So teaching, as we now understand it, may be one of those occupations that in the near future, I would dare say, will become obsolete.
Well, can we do it this way then? Because I'm not saying whether I agree or disagree with that. I'm just trying to say this. Isn't there, we say teaching, but teaching, there's two, well, in my brain, there's two teaching prongs, right? There's what we call education,
right?
And then there's what we call a training. Okay. They're both teaching, you know. Training is where you basically, I mean, a doctor is trained, a monkey is trained, a craftsperson, I guess craft work is trained, but then you're supposed to go on from there. Education is something else.
Well, it depends on how you define education and training. Training, other than when you're talking about human training, training is a form of education if it's applied properly. So it all depends on what we mean by education. For me, a basic definition of education goes like this. Education is the process of learning all things about one thing or all things about all things.
Stop. Say that one again.
Education, in the skeleton definition for me, is the process of learning all things about one thing or all things about all things. In fact, I actually got this definition from reading Neely Fuller. And what that simply means is that everything in the known universe is interrelated. And so if whatever we are learning about or being trained about is related to something else, and thus, if applied properly, training or education should be about the development of the human person, the human capability. Mm-hmm. If we look at our ancient ancestors, let's just take our ancient ancestors along the Nile Valley, but this would apply to our ancient ancestors anywhere in Africa. One of the things that our people would say was, man, know yourself. I'm going to say man and woman, know yourself. And what that simply means to me, and I hope it means to everybody, it simply means that the more one understands about themselves, the more one will understand about the universe around them. Thus, in that sense, one becomes, quote unquote, godlike. And the more information you have, the more, in so many words, the more you become dangerous. You become dangerous to those people who don't have information.
Now we've seen that time and time again. Right. Okay, I just want to stop right there. We're gonna go to something else. Okay, talk to you in a bit.
Turn it off for a second. Let me just see what this is.